It's time for The Match Game, Hollywood Squares, our whiz from St. Elsewhere, Ed Begley Jr. From Spain, Carlo Imperato. From WTHR in Indianapolis, Kim Hood. Jayne Kennedy. Jimmie. The stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
Those guys are fine work. You're okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right. How do you do, one and all? Everyone ready to have a go at it?
Yeah.
You feel comfortable in our presence?
Well, I can't get away from you. You're inescapable. Good.
We're delighted to have you with us. Delighted
Hello,
to have
Gene.
You. How are you today?
I'm very well. It's a pleasure to see you.
Thank you. Pleasure to see all of you. Shall we begin?
Yes.
Your sleeve is ripped.
A lot of places. From all the way over to here, all the way over to here.
Really? Well, they ripped it in the wrong spot, didn't they?
No.
All right. No, they didn't. All right. Let's say hello to our two players over here, Fran Austin and Jayne Wilson. Let's get acquainted. Fran, tell us about you, please.
I'm a homemaker. I live in Anaheim. I have two children, ages 22 and 12.
22 and 12.
Timing is everything.
Yes, right. That's show business.
I enjoy tennis and water skiing.
Good for you. You're a physically fit person if you do those things with some degree of regularity. All right, Fran, nice to have you with us. Hello, Jayne.
Hello.
Where are you from?
I'm from Parsons, Kansas.
No one's perfect. All right.
I was born a milkman's daughter there, moved to Hollywood to pursue my singing and acting career.
Yeah.
I've become a real valley girl, but instead of saying totally, I say utterly.
You
yeah,
do.
Yeah, right.
All right, Jayne. Nice to have you with us.
Thank you. I'll talk to my writers.
Let's begin the match game here. After the end of the third round, the one who's ahead will be declared the winner and go on to challenge a returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Fran won the toss. She'll go first.
B, please.
B. Mm-hmm. All right. You mustn't speak so quietly, Fran. We want to hear what you are saying.
Yes, please.
Because what you say is very important. So speak up.
Do you hear?
Yes.
Thank you. Here we go. Larry said, I just went to accommodation, fast food place, and drugstore. It was strange. I got a hamburger, French fries, and a bottle of blank. Everybody ready up there?
Yep.
Here we go. Fran. Larry said, I just went to accommodation, fast food place, and drugstore. It was strange. I got a hamburger, French fries, and a bottle of blank.
Attaboy.
Castor oil.
What's that?
Castor oil.
Castor oil.
Castor oil.
Castor oil.
Where have you been, Fran?
She's been playing tennis. Castor oil.
Castor oil.
Now, if you look at these people, look at these people.
Before
is there a bottle of castor oil among those stars? I would say no, but we got to go through the motions anyway and find out what
castor
they did say.
Oil.
Jayne.
Castor oil. I always associated when I was a little girl and my mom used to give it to me.
Yes.
Nowadays, it's Alka-Seltzer.
Alka-Seltzer. What'd you say?
I said K-O-Pectic.
Okay.
And I said Pepto-Bismol.
Pepto-Bismol. Those are the kinds of things we were looking for, Fran. You know, because fried foods and all that gives you the problem.
All right. She'll get two more chances with any luck.
Right.
Fran was wearing a pink outfit, so I said Pepto-Bismol.
There you go, John.
What'd you say?
Same answer, Pepto-Bismol.
Pepto-Bismol.
That's the outfit.
That's it. Wow, if you had said Pepto-Bismol,
right,
we would have had to end the show early. All right. Jim said to a psychiatrist, this is yours, Jayne. Jim is speaking to a psychiatrist. He says, Doc, I think I'm going crazy. I turned on my MTV, and I swear I saw blank in a rock video. Ready up here.
Ready.
And just about ready down here, so we'll go to Jayne Wilson. Jim said to the psychiatrist, Doc, I think I'm going crazy. I turned on my MTV, and I swear I saw blank in a rock video.
Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell. I guess it would be unlikely for Howard Cosell to be in a rock video, but there are other people, well, more unlikely other people. Jayne?
Well, the unlikeliest person I thought who would have fun with a rock video would be Jack Benny.
Right, and it would be very difficult because he is no longer with
right.
us.
Right, that's why he was going crazy.
Yes, oh, I see.
I said, knowing him very well and a good friend of mine, Larry Welk.
Larry Welk.
Larry's my man.
Jayne, I said this in the first show we did. Stick with Italians, baby. Howard Cosell.
Aha!
All right.
Whoa!
It's
a match.
I can't believe
it. Jayne Wilson, of course, is a well-known Italian.
Very John. Interesting. That's all I can say.
What have you got?
A matched Howard Cosell. Huh?
Right.
I have the man. You're a Valley girl. I have the man who owns the Valley, Lawrence Welk.
That's right.
A wonderful answer. Yeah, it's not really the Valley. It's just right. all of Los Angeles.
Stop the bubble machine.
Right.
I got him two.
Okay.
A one and a two and a three.
And a three. All right, Ed. So it's 1-0 in favor of Jayne at the end of round one. The second round will be long in a moment or so. First, this for you. Hurry back. Here we go with round two. Now... Jayne, you're ahead. You have to go first.
I'll pick B, please.
You want B. Here's the second round. First question for the second round. Hey, did you hear that the old lady who lived in the shoe just inherited some money?
No. How rich is she?
Yeah, she's very rich.
How much money did she inherit?
Well, it doesn't mean she... It was a lot of money. The first thing she did was have her house blanked. No right or wrong. Remember.
Yeah.
And it's round two.
What are you talking?
Hello, Jayne.
Hello.
What are you talking? How do you talk?
Now, listen carefully. Did you hear that the old lady who lived in a shoe just inherited some money? And the first thing she did was have her house blanked.
Polished.
Polished. That's good. Polished
That's
was
very good
one
answer.
Of the two nifty answers.
That's very good hilarious. Answer, but I...
You didn't say that.
I didn't have it. I had laced.
Laced. You know, new laces for the shoe.
Today.
That was a good answer, though. It really was. I said resold.
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 Yeah.
The crowd likes that. They know me now.
Jayne Wilson's looking for the answer polished. What do you
yes,
say?
Yes, I said shined, which I believe would be a match.
That it is, indeed. Two for Jayne. Kim.
I said resold.
Resold.
Yep.
Sold
all right.
and resold.
Sold and resold. All right, so there, Jayne picks up one, and Fran, you got a little catching up to do. Let's see if you do it with your round two question. At Waldo's house, the art patron said, he said, is that a Picasso? And Waldo replied, unfortunately not. I just stuck a frame around my wife's blank.
Okay, I'm ready. Thank you.
All right. Who wants this? Fran. At Waldo's house, the art patron said, is that a Picasso? And Waldo replied, unfortunately not. I just stuck a frame around my wife's blank.
Bottom.
Bottom? She's still speaking very quietly. Bottom is all right. What did you say?
Well... Don't think this is a bottom.
No, that's the other end.
That's the other end.
But that was the Picasso period when, he put yes. the ear and the cheek and all of that.
Yeah.
Blame Jayne for your problems, Fran. I said face.
Face. I think face is quite good. What do you got?
I thought it was quite good myself. I said face.
You said that. All right. The upper tier has face.
You mean that was as opposed to Picasso's blue period when he designed this set, right?
Right, yeah. Exactly.
I said, mother!
Mother! Okay.
A very sophisticated mother-in-law joke.
Right. All right, Kim.
Rear end.
Rear end. Sweet little innocent girl from Indianapolis comes through.
I'm a twisted guy, too. For some reason, I said rear end.
You said rear end. So we have a tie score at the end of round two. 2-2. All three deuces here. Be back right after this. Now, here we go. There's the third round coming up. I mean, yeah. And this is the last round. And since the score is tied, and she went first last time, Fran will ask you to go first this time.
B, please.
You want B. All right, four people play. The upper tier and John. Harvey said.
What?
Last night I dreamed I was a basketball player. When I woke up, I found I had slam dunked my wife into the blank.
I see.
Yeah, this is a fun one.
Yeah.
Yes, he's ready.
Yeah.
Is he ready?
He's ready.
What do you say, Fran? Harvey said last night I dreamed I was a basketball player. When I woke up, I found I had slam dunked my wife into the blank.
The toilet?
Wow.
Oh, geez, please.
That is such an obvious answer. Toilet.
You said it. All right.
I said, I tried not to say, so I said the toilet bowl, which is the same thing.
Right.
I couldn't say, I didn't want to have the whole thing written out.
It's rather distasteful to me, too. I agree with
you. Ego, friend, there's another one for you. Take it home. Take it home, baby.
She's up to five.
Clean it.
All she needs is you, John.
I cannot believe that a dignified, sophisticated woman such as Fran Austin.
Matron. Right.
Oh, I didn't want to say matron.
I said matron.
Would match an ungainly slob like me. Toilet.
Got them all. Jayne, the best you could do is achieve a tie. You could do that by matching the four stars you have matched. Kim, Ed, Jayne, and Jimmy. Here we go. Skinny Sally is so skinny.
It's skinny Sally.
Not bad. Not too terrific. Okay. Here's how skinny she is. When she puts on green stretch pants, she looks like a blank with a zipper. That's how skinny she is. Jimmy used to be skinny. When I first met him years ago, he was really skinny. That's it.
Not now, though. Total muscle and power.
Yeah.
Thank you, crowd. That's all right.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Jayne. Skinny Sally is so skinny, when she puts on green stretch pants, she looks like a blank with a zipper.
Well, it's one of two, but I'm going to say a green bean.
Green bean.
All right.
Green bean is another name for string bean, as we all know.
Yes.
Another name for string bean.
String bean. Yeah. 6-3 to score. Jimmy, are you laughing because you're going to break the magic spell?
I hate to do that. I said grasshopper.
Grasshopper. What the rest of you?
String bean.
Yeah. String beans all the way down. Come on down, friend. Okay, Jayne, good luck to you in your career here in singing and dancing. And we're going to send some gifts to Jayne Wilson. Hello there. How do you feel, friend?
Oh, fine now.
All right, here comes the rest of the furniture. We're going to switch to Hollywood Squares now. John and I will trade places. Lots more excitement coming along. Three stars are going to appear here by magic. And we'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Gibson's Variable Speed Washmaster Automatic Washer, designed to save time and energy, plus matching automatic dryer with AccuDry system for energy-efficient drying power furnished by Gibson. It's time for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Squares, our win from New Heart, Thom Poston. From Duck Factory, Nancy Lane. From Riptide, Thom, Bray. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bauman.
And we'll be back in just a minute to play Hollywood Squares. Join us.
Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Fran Austin, you said that thing, and you made it through the match game into Hollywood Squares. Congratulations.
Thank
good
you.
For you. We have three brand new celebrities. Thom Poston.
Yeah.
Nancy Lane. And Thom Bray. Thom Bray from Riptide right here on NBC, huh?
From Riptide, that's right, and Tuesday nights.
Yeah, one of our hits of the first season, which means that something happened recently.
We're back for next season, which is very nice.
Terrific.
Yes, thank you. We're all very excited about that.
Also, didn't you recently make an interesting trip for NBC on our behalf?
Yes, went down to the World's Fair, the opening of the World's Fair in Louisiana.
Uh-huh. Okay, well,
a lot of fun, wonderful city.
We're glad to have you back
and
with us. You're glad to have him here, Fran Austin. Let's go play Hollywood Squares. Here we go. Are you secure, Fran?
Yes, I am.
Atta girl. Now, this is one of those situations where we have a retired defending champion. She played for 5 days. She left here with a mere total of about $37,000 to go back and finish her senior year at college. So we were all crying and figuring out how we could possibly become contestants. These people drew lots backstage, three of them. Two of them wound up in match game. Fran survived. And the guy who drew the defending champion seat is named David Miller. Welcome to you.
Thank you.
Now, your uniform doesn't look much like my suit, David. Can you explain this?
Well, I'm a captain in the Marine Corps. I'm stationed at Marine Corps Air Station Tustin, California.
Uh-huh.
I'm originally from Florida, and I go to school at night studying travel agency operations.
Terrific. And what did you tell me a little bit earlier, too, about what your specialty is in the Marine Corps?
Intelligence.
So the real question is, does intelligence count in Hollywood Squares? We will soon find out. I have a feeling it's a combination of intelligence and instinct. So the two of you will help prove my point. We will play this game until you hear the time's up bell, and then one of you will go on to play Super Match, which can be worth up to $30,000. Okay, it's a lot of trips in the travel agency. Our first game's worth $100, $25 for every square. David Miller, pick a star.
Jimmy, please.
Jimmy Walker.
David in the service, look out. That's all right. No, please, no standing ovation if you must.
Your crowd is back. Jimmy, did the Musketeers have tails? Or were they only mice from the neck up?
Were they only mice from the neck up? That's right. They were only mice from the neck up. I think I know this pretty good because I watched it the other day on a Disney Channel. I really did. I'm sorry. I was crazy. My mind was going berserk. And it was on a Disney Channel and I watched it. They were Musketeers from the neck up. They didn't have little tails or anything.
No tails. Agree or disagree, David?
I agree.
Musketeers have no tails. Yes, sir. You're right to agree, sir. You got the square, sir. And you're up to a good start. Good for you. Fran Austin. He's
Jayne,
got one X up there. Place an O.
Jayne, please.
Jayne Rayburn.
Ready.
Yeah. Please enunciate the two of you between Jayne and Jayne. If you can say the last names, it'll help a little. According to American Health Magazine, who has a higher cholesterol level, Ronald Reagan or Walter Mondale?
Occasionally, one must guess here. Now, let's see. Cholesterol, Walter Mondale or... I believe your cholesterol rises as you get older. And therefore, I would attribute a higher level to Mr. Reagan.
Okay. He says Ronald Reagan has a higher cholesterol level. Agree or disagree? Fran?
I agree.
Walter Mondale, in fact, has a higher cholesterol level.
What
no, you should have disagreed. You should have disagreed, and your opponent gets that square. And Kim Hood from our affiliate in Indianapolis, who is a newswoman, is kind of shaking her head. Yes, I had also read this. It depends on what you read. Yeah, it's fairly well documented. Well, Mondale has had some sort, I don't know if you precisely call it problems, but in that department. And it is well publicized.
I think he's eating a cube of butter with every meal. I think that's part of it.
Oh, those were heart problems.
I think he has high blood pressure.
Heart problems.
Okay.
Heart problems.
Heart problems.
Got it, guys. But I
want
to tell you,
and there's the beef. Thom Poston up on the top tier. David Miller, your move.
Thom Bray to win, please.
Okay, this would give you the first game and 100 extra bucks.
Okay.
Mr. Bray.
Yes.
Today's special at the airport cafeteria is... chicken croquettes.
Yes, sounds like my lunch when they feed you at the show. Chicken croquettes.
Now, according to the Airline Pilots Association, can the pilot and co-pilot of an airliner both have the croquettes, or must they eat different meals?
Mm-hmm. I believe they have to eat different meals, just in case something goes funny with the croquettes.
Agree or disagree, David?
And if you've eaten the croquettes on any of the airlines, you know what I mean.
For the first game, do you agree or disagree?
I disagree.
An unpopular answer. And I'm afraid with very good reason. They will have to eat different meals. So you should have agreed with Thom, Bray, and your opponent gets that square and blocks you. And Thom, Bray's reasoning is right
on
the money.
That'll show you.
That's right. Airlines require crew members to eat different meals in case of food poisoning, which makes sense. Somebody's got to land the plane. Fran, you landed an O up there. Land another one.
Ed, please.
If you can.
Yes.
Ed Begley, Jr. from St. Elsewhere.
Yes.
In the Miss America pageant, this lady was Miss Chicago. Is she Nancy Reagan or Cloris Leachman?
What's the difference?
You bitter man.
Killing Thom.
There's a big
That's
difference.
That's Thom Poston of the Newhart Show. Address all letters, Thom Poston.
Yes.
I'm trying to remember where Nancy Reagan hails from. I don't think it's Chicago. I believe Cloris Leachman is from those parts. I've worked with her. And yes, I believe it's Cloris Leachman.
We have Cloris on the phone, Ed, if you'd like to.
So Ed says that Cloris Leachman was Miss Chicago. Agree or disagree, Fran?
I'll agree.
Cloris Leachman was Miss Chicago in the Miss America pageant. You're right to agree, and you get the square. Good for you. And in fact, Cloris Leachman became a runner-up for the title of Miss America. And a very good actress, by the way. We'll be back to complete our $100 game right after these messages.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
50 for the guy in the champ seat, and 50 for the lady in the challenger's seat, because neither of you is our actual champ. One of you will be by the end of the day. David Miller, your move.
Carlo to block, please.
Okay, now you missed this one. The first game belongs to Fran Austin. They're applauding blocking. You know, it's so exciting, Carlo.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much.
No, it's for you. When you reach your 70s, Carlo, which is a long way off, is it possible to still have zits? Or will you be safe?
Well, I don't know about zits. Never had the problem, never will, but... I think as you get older, acne becomes less and less possible. So I'd say when you're about 70, you don't have no problem.
He says you can't have zits when you're 70. What do you say, David, to block?
I agree.
You can have zits at 70. There was a lot of groaning from a lot of older people in their audience, I believe, with zits. But you shouldn't disagree with Carlo, and your opponent gets that square, and your opponent wins that game.
Sorry, Dave.
So... first, you are foiled by that. You see, you got to be in the Air Force because you got foiled by that airplane question. Anyway, Fran has jumped off to a bit of a lead here. She has 175 to 50, but we got plenty of time, so let's take those X's and O's off the board, and we'll start a $200 game with you, David.
Jimmie again, please.
Jimmie Walker.
Let's plow in.
You're cooking stalks of asparagus.
Look out.
Should the tips be pointing up or down?
Come on, Carlo, never safe, of course. I don't like asparagus because they get gooey and they jiggle out and everything. They're horrible, aren't they? Next question, John. Thank you so much. The crowd agrees. Next question. Sorry, we're not moving. Asparagus, I would say I've seen them boil up. So they seem to boil naturally to the upward tendency of the stalk. So I would go that way.
Point your tips up, he says. Agree or disagree when cooking stalks of asparagus?
I agree.
Your tips should be pointing up. Yes, you're right to agree. You get the square and get yourself off to a good start in this game. Fran Austin, he's got one X. You need an O.
Gene Rayburn, please.
Gene Rayburn.
No applause, please. He's already
not
enough.
Gene, has a dairy cow ever lived to be 50? Or is that ridiculous?
50-year-old cow, you say? Huh. 25, yes, I've heard of that. But 50, wow. Multiplied by 7? It's 350 years in human terms. Can't be. I say no.
Never live to be 50.
No.
Agree or disagree, Fran?
I'll agree.
A cow has never lived to be 50.
Never.
You're right to agree, and you get the square. Good for you. The oldest living cow, the oldest living dairy cow, lived to be 39.
I have one that's 35.
Well, or at least that's when she started lying about her age. David Miller, it's your move. You're playing X.
Thom Poston, please.
Okay, Mr. Poston.
Capitano.
Into the breach. It's Liberace's birthday. Woo. And as a special treat, you clean his piano keys. According to Mary Ellen, what should you rub on them? Toothpaste or white wine?
Hey, toothpaste or white wine? Toothpaste or white wine? Listen, see, the point is that what we say up here has no bearing on anything. They have to decide on their own, right? Whether we're right or wrong.
Yes,
I can say anything. It doesn't make any difference.
Well, I'd prefer it if you said either toothpaste or white wine.
The captain has to decide. So I'll say white wine.
Okay, he says white wine to clean Liberace's piano keys. Agree or disagree, David?
I'll agree.
You should rub toothpaste on to clean Liberace's piano keys. So you should have disagreed with Thom. Toothpaste will clean your piano keys. And don't forget to floss. Fran, you're playing Ho, pick a star.
Jayne to win.
Okay, now this would give you the game and a pretty decent-sized lead. Jayne Kennedy, in the U.S., what is the most popular children's book of all time? Is it The Tale of Peter Rabbit or The Cat in the Hat?
Ooh, that's close, because both of those are pretty popular. I was going to say Fun with Dick and Jayne, because that's what they always used to tease me about.
Don't mind if I do.
Let me see. Peter Rabbit or...
It's either Tale of Peter Rabbit or The Cat in the Hat
Seuss.
By Dr. Seuss, right.
I'm just going to go with Dr. Seuss, the Cat in the Hat.
Okay, she says The Cat in the Hat for the game. Do you agree or disagree that that was the most popular children's book of all time in this country?
I disagree.
In the United States, a big audible groan from celebrities and the audience. In the United States, the most popular children's book of all time was The Tale of Peter Rabbit. You were right to disagree. You get the square. You win the game. And everyone can stop groaning except for David Miller, who will probably continue to groan during these 2 minutes worth of commercials. And then we'll come back and try to catch up. See you then. Okay, 475 for Fran Austin and 75 for David Miller. We are beginning, however, a $300 game, so this can make a substantial difference in those totals. David, start us off.
I have to go with Jimmie again.
We have hit him every time so far, and we missed this one. That's one out of three, which in the major leagues would make us big money. One out of three, all you need in the major leagues to make a lot of money.
Here you go.
Let's go.
Who has had more gold records in his career, Jimmie? Frankie Avalon or Lawrence Welk?
Ha! Two of my favorites. Two, let me look at my book here and see. Larry. I just mentioned Larry in the match game, didn't I? Larry Welk or Frankie Avalon? Now, Frankie had my dear friend Larry is a dear friend of mine. And Frankie had a lot in the early 50s, middle 50s. Because the obvious one would be Frankie Avalon, obviously. So I'm going to go with Larry Welk, my dear friend.
Okay, he says Lawrence Welk has had more gold records. Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
Lawrence Welk has had more gold records in his career than Frankie Avalon, so you should have agreed with Jimmie Walker.
You've been going with me. What happened?
Your opponent gets that square, but here are the statistics, which are kind of interesting. Frankie Avalon never had a gold record. Okay? Lawrence Welk had one for a song called Calcutta. Remember? That's it. Okay, Fran Austin. You got 1-0. Pick a star for another one.
Jayne Rayburn, please.
Jayne Rayburn.
Ready for you, Fran?
You're a typical Indian cobra being charmed by a typical Indian snake charmer. Mm-hmm. Now, is your charmer incredibly brave to risk getting bitten by you? Or is he incredibly smart, having removed your fangs?
I believe he's incredibly smart, having removed my fangs.
Okay. He says the fangs have been removed. Agree or disagree, Fran?
I'm speechless.
I agree.
The typical Indian snake charmer would have removed the typical Indian cobra's fangs. So you are right to agree, which is also becoming typical today because you've got a lot of money up there on the board. Here's a great thing, though. Our source actually said this. A few snake charmers don't remove the fangs, but their careers are noticeably shorter. Go source. David Miller, your move for an X.
Thom Bray to Brock, please.
Blocking.
Thom Bray to Brock. Okay.
We're blocking.
Now, you miss this one, then it's really a pretty big lead for Fran. You're going to have a lot of catching up to do. Thom Bray, can a crocodile sleep with his eyes open? Or is it impossible for him to get any shut-eye that way?
Shut-eye. I think that a crocodile can sleep definitely with its eyes open because it's got to be able to tell if there are any predators out there.
He says a crocodile.
Predators, big word, predators. Or creditors, for that matter, because they go wild when they go into town. You know, you give them those charge cards and...
So Thom says a crocodile can sleep with his eyes open.
Yes.
Okay, now agree or disagree for a very important block, David.
I agree.
A crocodile sleeps with his eyes closed. I'm afraid. Close your eyes because you should have disagreed. Your opponent gets that square and wins that game. Don't look at what happened up on that board, David Miller. Crocodiles cannot sleep with their eyes open. It's 825 for Fran Austin, 75 for David Miller. But we will clear the O's off of the board and start a $400 game. We will start it with you, David. Try to pick up some money.
Oh, let's end it
now. Come on, Dave, let's
please.
Do it.
It's too much. It's brutality here.
Pick a star.
Nancy, please.
Oh. That's all right. That's all right. Don't worry about it. Nancy, let's get out of here. We've had enough of this.
Nancy Lane,
yes,
when
sir.
Your zipper is stuck, should you...
Yes.
This will lighten things up. When your zipper is stuck, should you rub it up and down with a pencil? Or should you aim a hot blow dryer at it?
What kind of zipper is this? I mean, is it metal or plastic? Okay, wait.
It's your zipper,
Nancy.
It's my
zipper.
Yes.
Which means...
Okay, should you rub it up now with a pencil? That's lead.
I'm assuming that it's metal. It's metal.
It's lead.
Yeah. Thank you, producer.
And or what was the blow dryer? Just a blow dryer? That's all you said?
Just a blow dryer.
Or aim
no,
a blow
you
dryer
should,
at it?
You could either rub it up and down with a pencil.
Right.
Or aim a hot blow dryer at it.
If it's stuck. I think rub it with a pencil because hot... This is terrible. Because the hot air would make the metal expand, I think, and then it wouldn't work.
So you say rub it up and down with a pencil.
Yeah, I really
what do you say, David?
I agree.
You should rub it up and down with a pencil. Yes, you're right to agree, and you get the square. So good. $25 is $25. Fran Austin, your move for an O.
Jimmy, please.
Jimmy Walker.
Back in. Without Dave. We're in. Now I'm on the winning side now.
Jimmy, what weighs more, Jim? The average one-year-old baby or the average professional bowling ball?
Now, I know bowling. I'm a big bowler. I love to bowl. Bowling balls are 16-pounders. But there was a baby just born to a woman, 320 pounds, a baby born 18 pounds. This is true. I don't know, you know, whatever. I just want to throw out to the crowd and make sure that they know that I'm hip. Anyway, okay.
That's the average one-year-old baby.
The average one-year-old baby.
The baby is not drilled.
I would say a bowling ball weighs more because a bowling ball is 16 pounds. But there's bowling balls from 12 to 16 pounds, so we go with the bowling ball.
Agree or disagree, Fran? He says the bowling ball weighs more.
I disagree.
The average one-year-old baby weighs more. You are right to disagree, and you get the square. And for someone who's sitting in that challenger seat, you are proving to be an excellent player. Because the average one-year-old baby weighs about 20 pounds. The bowling ball, as Jimmy said, average professional bowling ball weighs about 16. David, you got tough competition. Pick a star.
Thom Poston, please.
Semper. Semper Fidelis.
Thom, you're going to a coming out party, but the debutante is a real dog.
Ah.
Now, according to the 1935 edition of Vogue's Book of Etiquette,
feed her kibbled food.
Kibble-a-bits.
Not one of the choices here. Must you ask her to dance? Or is it okay just to shake her hand and wish her well?
That you're escorting the Deb?
No. You're just a guest at the coming out party.
A guest at the coming out party. You may shake her hand and wish her well. Okay. Not having nothing to do with how ugly she is or not. That's just etiquette.
So you don't have to ask her to dance. Agree or disagree, David?
I agree.
You must dance with her. No, your phone gets that square. You shouldn't disagree. Yes. See, what's happening is there's a lot of agreeing with a lot of celebrities who don't know what
too much,
talking about. Yeah. And the bell means that time is up. She has done it. Fran Austin has earned the seat. $875. Congratulations. Good for you. That is quite a performance.
Thank you.
6 for 6 in the match game. Matched everybody. And now a very convincing win in Hollywood Squares. Zip yourself right over there. Join Jayne. Get sent for your shot at the big money. Good for you. Well, intelligence.
Did not pay off.
Combined with instinct, I know. But it is a tricky game. I mean, it's hard to figure out these things. She did very well. You left or leaving here with $100. And our thanks for being here. David Miller, congratulations. Okay, Fran and Jayne, take
it. All right, here's the lady who knocked over the Marine Corps. We'll be back with her and the stars for going the big dough right after this.
And now, here to play the super match is Jayne Raymer.
Thank you very much, Gino. Here we go. And go. Now, Fran is very excited because this is her first time up here.
Yes, it is.
You've gotten over all the hurdles, and you knocked off the Marine Corps. And here in the super match, you could win up to $30,000, shall we?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Going blank. If you give us the answer they wrote down most frequently, it's $1,000, for the second, $500, and for the third, $250. Now, whom do you call on for a little assist here?
John, please.
Thanks a bunch. Boy, going... Going out.
Going out is John's?
Nancy.
Going my way.
Going my way?
Here you go, baby.
Ed, please.
Going berserk.
Going berserk.
It's a movie title.
Yeah.
Boy, it's a funny question.
All right. Now, those are the three they've given you. Going out, going my way, and going berserk. And I must say, you have a difficult choice here, because you are faced with a dilemma of choosing one of those or thinking up one of your own. Now, what would you like to do?
I even went, ooh, 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 ooh.
Going blind. We have the winner.
Do you have a good one? All,
think it over now.
We're not going to tell you.
Going my way.
Going my way. All right, we'll find out if going my way is out there, and if so, where?
Going home.
Going home, which we had here.
Yes, we did.
Going home, you think it's going to be out there? Well, here's some others here. Let's take a look at the $250 response.
Going to the dog.
Going home is one that was up there.
That's right. Leave us out from now on. You'll see what happens.
Okay. The $500 response says... Going, gone.
But if you have
here in the middle.
Right there.
But yeah. What, you got all baseball fans in the audience?
That's right.
Going, gone is a good one. What do you think is under the $1,000 audience?
My way. My way.
Going crazy.
They don't have an answer, do they?
Going nowhere.
All right, slide
going
it, Steve.
Going crazy.
Going
right.
My way.
Right.
All right, Nancy. Now it's time for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after you've made your decision, that star will reveal the hidden number there, and we'll multiply your $1,000 by whatever number is revealed. It'll be a 10, a 20, and somewhere up there is 130.
John, please.
All right, John, let's see what your hidden number is today. It is a 20. So you're playing for $20,000. All right. No help from the audience, please. Remember, if you hear the answer, we got to throw it out and start all over. Cape blank. That's C-A-P-E.
What is it?
C-A-P-E. Cape blank. All right, John's made up his mind. cards in the slot. You collect the $20,000 simply by matching him. What do you say?
Cape Cod.
You say Cape Cod. All right. I'm on the red eye tonight at 10 o'clock. I'm on my way off there. What do you say, John?
And, you know, because you live there,
yeah,
it's in my consciousness. So, of course, I don't know whether it's in everyone's. There's another real good one.
Most popular tourist spot in America.
I understand, but there's another real good one. Cape Kennedy.
Right.
So I said Cape Cod.
Yay! $20,000. And a way to go, Fran. Fran, you've got $21,875. A lot of money for you. All right, we'll be back with the champ of the stars right after this. Find out where the big 3-0 was. Stars, would you all grab the tabs and give them a yank? Ready, set, go. See you tomorrow, Fran. Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Bowman saying so long for the Match Game, Hollywood Square, Sarah. See you then.
A member of our studio audience will receive Hitachi 13-inch diagonal table model color TV. 100% solid state, low power consumption, special signal tracker system, memory fine tuning, 70 position UHF tuner furnished by Hitachi. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.